These little relaxation, Sunday night, afternoon, evening in the park. We'd like to open up the program with a British composer, Hayden Wood, who wrote some lovely tunes from northern England and into Scotland and Ireland area. This he wrote from a Paris suite. Our opening number is Montmartre. Hear the sounds of France, Paris, and the busy streets and the typical wonderful French atmosphere. Montmartre by Hayden Wood.
Thank you.
even the slightest bit of wind. Unfortunately, the wind is coming in this direction, so when I open up the score, it's like the pages keep falling over. It came from this way, I wouldn't have to worry about that. I hope you enjoy that, a little bit of Paris. And now we go to Broadway, and it all began with this particular show, which became the blueprint for the modern day Broadway musical. 1929, and Showboat hit the Broadway stage. What makes Showboat so unique is that the Broadway shows before Showboat, like Ziegfeld Follies, Gilbert and Sullivan operettas, all were basically skits that had musical numbers in between. The Showboat told a whole story, and the music in the show was in character to what was happening that moment in the story. Well, it completely revolutionized Broadway, became an instant hit. Its themes in the show were very, very powerful, dealing with African Americans and white people, not intermingling, marriages that weren't consummated the proper way, things that you wouldn't have seen in typical 1929 Broadway. It's been revised on Broadway at least a half a dozen times, made into a musical, and some of the tunes you'll hear today still are so memorable. So we'd like now to present to you selections from Showboat.
Thank you.
I never told you who composed Showboat. Jerome Kern, one of the great song stylists of the 20s, 30s, 40s, and 50s. So now, we want to do a piccolo solo. And when the time came and I asked our piccolo soloist to pick solo, we couldn't find any. She said, can we do a duet? And I said, sure, why not? Well, she said, we did this duet in high school. Well, sorry to say, okay. And it turned out to be a really, really lovely duet, which I'm sure you're going to enjoy. So I'd like to introduce Cindy Petter and Carol Smith in, I love the title, Two Little Bullfinches Polka. I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
You can see the birds really love that. They added so beautifully to our music, and in G too, you notice that. So we thank Cindy and Carol. Now I can turn the microphone over to our flautist and band narrator, Miss Margaret Reynolds, to introduce our next selection.
Kings Park Concert Band is pleased to play for you some excerpts from Carnival of the Animals. Camille Saint-Saëns composed Carnival of the Animals in 1886, which was 16 years before the American poet Ogden Nash was born. By the time Ogden Nash had reached his stride as a successful writer of humorous poetry, Carnival of the Animals had become popular all around the world. Ogden Nash must have had great fun writing short introductory poems about each creature represented in the music. Here is what he wrote about the composer in his introduction. Camille Saint-Saëns was racked with pain when people addressed him as Saint Saints. He held the human race to blame because he could not pronounce his name. So he turned with metronome and fife to glorify other kinds of life. Be quiet, please, for here begins his salute to feathers, fur, and fins. Is the king of beasts and husband of the lioness. Gazelles and things on which he feasts address him as your highness. There are those that admire that roar of his in the African jungles and veldts. But I think that anywhere the lion is, I would rather be somewhere else.
Thank you.
useful friends, equipped with handles at both ends. They have a wrinkled, moth-proof hide. Their teeth are upside down, outside. If you think elephants are preposterous, you've probably never even seen a rhinoceros. And brontosauruses sang ghostly prehistoric choruses amid the mastodonic wassail. I caught the eye of one small fossil. "Cheer up, sad world," he said, and winked. "It's kind of fun to be extinct."
Thank you.
of an Animale Carnivale. Noises new to sea and land issue from the skillful band. All the flutes contort their features, imitating crawly creatures. All the brasses look like mumps from blowing oompa oompa oomps. In outdoing Barnum and Bailey and Ringling, Saint-Saëns has done a miraculous thingling.
Japanese word for fireworks. It was a 1998 film that had great critical success, especially in the Asian market. And the composer, Joe Hisaishi, is well renowned in Japan and many, well, I guess in Europe, not as much here in the United States, and I think he should be. This is a beautiful lilting melody from this movie, Hanabi, from Fireworks rather. I'd like to present to you this melodic excerpt, Hanabi.
Thank you.
It's a very haunting melody, and when I heard that for the first time, I said, I just have to do that for our concert band, and I hope you enjoyed it. Well, one of the pleasures of not only being a retired educator, but also being able to conduct the community band, is to have former students of Fairfax County Public Schools who were in the band as an extracurricular activity, went on, graduated from school, and came back to the area, married, and asked to come back and play bassoon in the band again. And of course we said, absolutely. So we'd like to introduce to you Molly Ramirez Gaston, correct? Yes. And she's going to do a piece for us tonight. It's really a lot of fun. It's called Der Alte Brunberg. So, featuring Molly on bassoon. Normally, ladies and gentlemen, would have had the soloist come up front here, but there's no room, so she's over there. Molly, raise your hand so that people don't know what the bassoon looks like. Okay, here.
Thank you.
And Molly just do a beautiful job. Give her one more hand. Well, no concert by a band would be complete unless we played a march by the great John Philip Sousa. And we discovered this march actually was released on the internet. Sousa wrote all of them you should know or be familiar with. And he called this march Mother Hubbard March. So even though it's Father's Day, Mom's got to help a little bit. Mother Hubbard March by John Philip Sousa. We are the Kings Park Band, and it's almost time for us to complete our musical journey for this afternoon. But we have two tunes left for you, and because of the time, we're going to skip one of the selections. We're going to play for you a wonderful arrangement of 76 trombones. And it's cool because you're going to hear 76 trombones, the Stars and Stripes, National Emblem March, maybe some other tunes in there. But we'd like to play for you now, 76 trombones.
Thank you. yes, Kings Park. I don't know which I like better, 76 trombones or hearing in public a long-forgotten Sousa march. Sousa only wrote about 220 marches in his career, but he wrote 2,400 other pieces of music. That stuff is now being published by Naxos. They now have out, I think, about their 22nd CD. They're all being recorded overseas by Royal Somebody or Other bands. But it's wonderful stuff, and it's all on Naxos. It's things that you've heard, but mostly things that you've never heard. What a great talent Sousa was. And what a great talent we have here on the stage tonight. Let's have another round of applause for Kings Park. Thank you all.
How about one more tune before we go? One more tune, Salute to America. God Bless America.
Absolutely. Musicians would get together and learn the melodies from each other and make sure that they had their repertoire right up to date. Now, the Kemplin's acoustic jam is just that. It's a jam session. There's a core group that comes in and actually forms a small band. And then anybody with an instrument or a vocal that they would like to do can come in and, while they're having their jam session and take part. The only real entrance fee is this combines the best of improvised music with a church social, so you have to bring a covered dish. But other than that, if you go on the internet and you look up the Kent Winds Acoustic Jam, listen to some of the stuff that the core group does, and it performs publicly all over Northern Virginia and southern Maryland. They're going to be with us next week, first time on our stage, so we'll see just exactly how they do. So, love to see you next week. Let's have one more round of applause for Kings Park.